Welcome back to this Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn Let's Play. You're with Sambo, and oh my lord, can you believe it? Here we are, episode 1, finally after all of this time. Firstly, a big thank you to everyone who watched last week's show, episode 0. That was very, very exciting, and of course, very informative for us in terms of dictating how we go through the game and setting up a character for us here in Realm Reborn, and we're going to expand on that more today. I would also like to say a very, very big thank you to all of the Distant World members who I know are waiting in the wings right now and who have been playing the game for the past few days. Certainly hope you guys are enjoying the game. Big shout out to you and thanks for being such a wonderful community. And of course, can't wait to see you guys all online. If you're watching along from home, then hey, welcome to a brand new chapter in Distant World's community history. Here we are, can you believe it, in A Realm Reborn. Finally, after all of this time and after saying a very sad goodbye to version 1, here we are in version 2. And you know what, without further ado, I'm going to hit the start button here, and that will bring me into my character selection screen. And as you can see, and as you know from last week's episode, we've got a legacy status down here, and that means that what we're staring at right there is my version 1.0 character. This is, folks, Seraphis Thrallwyn from version 1, from our version 1 Let's Play series. And right now, I haven't done a thing to her. You can see here, this is indeed her. She is a Marauder level 32. And of course, if you followed along in our version 1 series, you'd already know that. We are on the world of Masamune, also a hangover from our version 1 series. And just a reminder that that is a legacy server, but you are able to create a character there if the server is open. This is a good time just to remind you guys that we do have a fallback server, and that is Moogle. M-O-O-G-L-E, and there's more information about that in the link below, but make sure that if Masamune is full, that you go enroll on Moogle if you'd like to hang out with us online. Seraphis Thrallwyn, this is her. This is our Marauder, and you know what? If I click on her, if I want to go into the world, you see that I get a bit of a menu pop-up here, and it says, to log in with this character from version 1.0, you must first specify the Disciple of War or magic class that you wish to begin the game as. You are also granted one opportunity to edit your character's race, tribe, gender, appearance, and name. And this is a really important thing, folks. If you are about to log in on a legacy character, just remind yourselves that you have one and only one opportunity to make any changes to the look, the race, the tribe, the gender, whatever, of your character. Now, that's a free opportunity given to you by Square Enix. Make sure you choose to use it wisely. Once you log into the world, you will lose that opportunity. So I, of course, am going to click on OK here, and you'll see it's taken us to an actual character creation screen. Now, we don't need to go through this right now, because if you have a look at last week's episode, episode 0, all of the options in the character creator are explained there. So make sure you go and watch that if you haven't already. Myself, I'm going to choose not to make any changes at all to Seraphis Thrallwyn here. So she's going to be exactly the same lady that she was in our last series, because I like her look. So you can see all of her stats are listed down the right hand side there. We've got the fact that she's a Miqo'te, of course, she's a cat lady, she's a seeker of the sun. We've got a custom appearance there, that's because it's pulling it through from version 1. We've got my name day and my guardian, and we've got the current class that she is, and you'll notice there that in brackets it says Limza. Interesting, we'll talk about that in just a minute. You'll see the world is already pre-selected. I'm on Masamune, and I certainly hope you guys get a chance to join us there. And you can see my name is Seraphis Thrallwyn. Now, as I mentioned before, you can see there, we all know I'm a Marauder, and I love being a Marauder, but it has, in brackets, Limza. This is one of the big changes with version 2.0, with A Realm Reborn. Now, your actual character class is tied to a starting city. Now, that's a big change from version 1, where you could pretty much select your own starting city. Now, it is locked in to a specific set of classes. So, in my case, Marauder is tied to Limza. Now, we all know that I'm a huge fan of Gridania. Not only that, but my grand company is in in Gridania, and I really, really want to go through that particular storyline and begin there when I load into the world anew. So what I'm going to have to do here is click on Marauder, and here we go. You can see, just like last time, we've got a grand selection of Disciples of War and Disciples of Magic. Now, if I expand the Disciples of Magic here, you can see I've got Conjurer, Thaumaturge, and Arcanist. Now, the Arcanist begins in Limsa Lamenta. The Thaumaturge begins in Ul'dah, and you can see that down there on the bottom left. Conjurer, however, actually begins in Gridania. And you can see there the eastern reaches of the Eldenard landmass, home to vast, dense woodlands. You know what? You had me at hello. Vast, dense woodlands is exactly where I want to be, and that means that I'm going to have to choose Conjurer as my class. Now, you guys know that Final Fantasy XIV has a very flexible class system. It does not actually matter that I choose Conjurer. I'm still going to be a level 32 Marauder, don't worry about that, but in order to get into Gridania, I'm going to have to select Conjurer now, and that is quite okay. So let's select that. You can see if I spin my character around, there she is, she's got a cane on her back. And don't forget, folks, that you can also check yourselves out in all of these different environments here, and you can see the different times of day, so we can adjust that to nighttime or, in this case, evening. There we are. And don't forget, you can also see your character with the job attire, and I just click on that button there, and there we go. You can see I've got my AF gear for a Conjurer, and you can also, if you want, take off all of your clothes, although my name is not Jenna Blossom, so I want to wear some clothes. There we go. That is the familiar Seraphis Thrallwyn that we know and love, even though I am a Conjurer. So making sure that I've got Conjurer selected here, and again, spinning around, you can see I've got my cane. Make sure that it says Gridania down the bottom left, and again, I urge you guys to make double, triple sure that you are choosing the starting area and therefore quest line that you are most interested in. You know, your choices are Gridania, Limsa Lamenta, or good old Ul'dah. We're going to Gridania. As soon as I click on this confirm button here, hopefully we're going to get taken through back into the world that we loved and knew back in version 1.0 and see it as it's transformed here into a Realm Reborn version 2.0. As you can well imagine, Square Enix will have conjured us up a fantastic cutscene in order to bridge that gap, and you're about to view that right now. We'll see you on the other side.
Yeah. The Black Shroud, the ancient forest, close to the heart of Eorzea. Beneath the boughs of its towering trees lies the woodland city-state of Gridania. Once a sanctuary from the world beyond the hedge, even the mighty elementals, eternal guardians of the forest, could not forestall the coming of the seventh umbral era. However, the goddess Nofika was never one to forsake her children, and today she welcomes another brave soul. One who may yet play a telling role in the tale of this great realm. May the matron take her to her bosom, that she may never want. And in her heart, sow serenity, purity, and sanctity.
Welcome, folks. This is it. We are now in what I like to call the lobby area of Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. As you can see, I'm already being prompted here to select a control scheme, and that brings up a great point, which is, of course, if you wish, you can play this game with a gamepad. It's fully supported. Any gamepad that your current Windows version recognizes will be able to be used here. I actually have a PS3 controller that I'd like to try it with, but for now, I'm going to be using mouse and keyboard. And this brings up another neat little feature here that is new in version 2, A Realm Reborn, and that is a series of tutorials. You can see here I've got a couple of things on the screen. Down the bottom, it's saying follow the instructions to move your character and adjust the position of the camera. And up the top here, we've got this great big question mark with the basic controls window. Now, if you are a veteran to Final Fantasy XIV or any MMO, you can feel free to go ahead and tick this box here, which is disable all active help windows. I'm going to leave them up for now, just so you guys can see exactly how much work has been put in by Yoshi P and the team at Square Enix to make sure that this is a seamless experience. I'm going to dismiss that window, and you can see to get rid of any text down the bottom, all you need to do is click when you are ready to proceed, speak to Bertenant. Now, this is a great opportunity for me to just run through a couple of things with you guys. As you can see, we are out in the world and it looks gorgeous. This is what Final Fantasy XIV A Realm Reborn looks like, and I'm sure that you will agree it looks absolutely fantastic. fantastic, especially here in my favorite land of Gridania. Now, a couple of things to note. This game has gone through a significant overhaul in terms of the UI. Now, we'll be catching up with the rest of our familiar distant world folk very, very soon, and I'm sure that they'll be able to give me a whole bunch of tips and tricks and information about how the UI looks now. But I'm sure that you guys watching along from home can tell just by looking at it that it will probably look very, very familiar. That's right, they have abandoned the old Final Fantasy way, and now what they're doing is making it look a lot more like the standard MMO that you and I are used to. So of course we've got our mini map up in the top right now. We've got the chat down the bottom there. That, by the way, you no longer use a space bar to actually chat. And in fact, if I hit enter, there we go, and if I type in hello, there it is. It is that simple. It is just like every other theme park MMO now, and I love it. It is so familiar. By the way, speaking of which, if you'd like to adjust any of these elements, there are very, very detailed options available to you. But right now, all I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this. If you hover on general, there you go. Hold down your mouse button on the word general. You can now grab this chat element and move it to wherever you like. I'm just going to move it across to the left a little bit more. In the top right of that window, you can see my cursor changes to a funny little arrow symbol. That means I can stretch the chat out to the size that I like. Now I like it just a little bit bigger than the default, and there it is. Now once again, don't worry, we'll go through all of the UI stuff in detail throughout the course of the opening episodes of our series. For now, I'd also like to just quickly show you that if you click on this chat bubble, you can set the filter for the channel that you're talking in. And right now I'm just in say, which means anything I type in here is just going to be seen locally. Now we'll go through that in more detail later. The other thing I want to be able to do is grab these hot bars here. You can see I've got a couple of hot bars, and I'm just going to hover over the number one and grab this and drag it down a little bit. Also going to do the same to my hot bar number two, and don't worry, I'll show you later on how you can add hot bars and how you can actually shift all of the elements of your HUD, and indeed what all of these funny little icons mean. For now, all we need to know is that M is for map, and you can see yet another great thing. All of our quest objectives actually come up on the map, and as you'll see in just a moment, we even get a quest tracker down the right hand side of the screen, which we can click on to open our journal and find where we need to go. So first question you may have is, how hard is it to get around in A Realm Reborn? It is as easy or difficult as you choose. If you'd like to follow the markers on the minimap, you can do just that. If you'd like to read the quest text and figure it out for yourself, you can do that as well. But as you can see, it is all very familiar. M for map, C for character, and we'll go through all of these later. You've got I for your inventory, and that's all we need to know right now. Of course, it's WASD if you're on the keyboard. If I hold down my left mouse button and pan the camera around, my character doesn't move. If I hold down the right mouse button, she does move. I can hold down right and left buttons to make her run, and that there is indeed what the running animations look like in A Realm Reborn, and I'm sure you'll agree, they still look fantastic. Now you see here that I've tried to run out the back door, and look what's happened. Didn't you hear me? Come here and I shall guide you. And I'm being automatically walked back to the beginning. So if I try and escape this area here, in fact, we're going to run past Bertinet. Oh, there we go. And look at that. Didn't you hear me? Come back. We get sent straight back to him. So you can't get out of here until you've spoken to him. Now you see I've got a little help icon come up here. Whenever that pops up, you're free to click on the question mark, and it will tell you in great detail everything you need to know about the particular function you're trying to access. So you can see here, non-player characters, NPCs, offering quests can be recognized by the exclamation marks above their heads. Right-click the mark to bring up the quest window. And it's that simple. So let's have a click on him. In fact, and there we go. This is what the new quest looks like. You can see here, coming to Gridania. You can see we've got a couple of rewards here, XP 50 and good old Gil of 103 to be recognized as an adventurer in the city state of Gridania. And boy, do I ever. You must first register yourself with the Adventurers Guild. And you can see we've got this little helper window come up here. Once you've initiated a quest, a prompt will appear detailing its objectives and rewards. And I love that as well. It's very easy to see what you're going to get from completing this quest. Click on the accept button in the lower left to add the quest to your list of current duties. So I'm going to do just that. Another green adventurer, I presume. Well, yes, I am a little bit green. I wonder if he knows all about me. I thought as much. We cannot allow strangers to wander Gridania unchecked and untested. Before you rush off and begin pestering every second citizen for work, I suggest you make yourself known at the Carline Canopy. That's the headquarters of the local Adventurers Guild, in case you were wondering. The Carline Canopy is the building you see behind me. Speak to Mother Mion within, and she will take you in hand. And there we go. Quest accepted. You have begun a quest. Use the duty list to help complete your task. And you can see again, we've got a help window pop up here. And look at that, underneath the mini-map, that is, I call it a quest tracker, but its formal name is the duty list. Upon accepting a quest, the current objectives will appear under the quest title in the duty list on the right side of the screen. A maximum of 5 quests can be tracked at once. And you can see we've actually got 2 windows available to us here in the help menu. Clicking on the title will open the quest in your journal, allowing you to reconfirm the objectives and rewards. And I love this. And of course, they're taking a cue here from every other current MMO, and I don't care. It is fantastic. You can see if I click on the quest title here in the duty tracker called Coming to Gridania, look at that. This is my quest journal. And here down the left-hand side are the list of quests. I've currently only got 1, of course. And over here, we can see we've got the details. Now, the great thing about this is you might notice I've got a map button down the bottom right. If I click on that, 10 points to anyone who can guess. That's right. You can see it actually brings up the area for the quest and shows me the location of the objective that I have, which in this case is to speak with Mion. And you can see we've got a great big bright green tick down there. You can see I am the little blue pick down the bottom there. It looks like a guitar pick. The blue pip on the map, that is me. I can actually drag this map around as well. Now, just so you know, you can also resize that map to any size you like. And if I want to, I can spin around my character, and in real time, it is showing me the direction I'm facing. So I know I need to head up that road towards the roost and then head down into the Carline Canopy. By the way, on the map screen, you can see we've got a world version. I can zoom in and out with my mouse wheel. That's what I'm doing right there. Or I can go and center the map on my location. So these tools here are fantastic. Love it. And by the way, you've got a zoom in and zoom out on the mini map here as well. Now you can also lock or unlock this compass so you can move it around. Up the top there, it does show me that it's 12:13 p.m. here in Australia. It's during the day, and yes, there is a day-night cycle and plenty of fantastic weather here in Eorzea, and you'll get to see that as our show progresses. But right now, I need to come to Gridania. I need to go and speak with Mion. Let's go and get rid of that dialogue. Hopefully now, I'm going to be able to walk through here without being sent back. And look at that, we are heading into Gridania. This, of course, is a familiar sight to you guys. If you've been watching our Let's Play 1.0 series, you'll know that we spent many a day here in the Adventurers Guild, and the layout is exactly the same. It looks a little different now, but in terms of the major landmarks, you're not going to get lost. Let's have a look out here, and what did I just do? What happened? That's right, Seraphis is jumping. Instead of hitting spacebar to chat now, again, as you know, you can just hit enter, just like every other MMO. If I hit the spacebar now, that is correct. There is jumping in Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn, and I couldn't be any happier. There's something about jumping. I don't know what it is, but I love it in my MMOs. By the way, I don't know if you noticed there, when I said hello in chat, let's do it again. Watch Seraphis' mouth. In fact, we're going to zoom right in on her. Let's do it one more time. Hello. And you can see she actually mouths the words. It's absolutely fantastic. I love it. The attention to detail here, folks, is still present. There were lots of people who were concerned that the game was going to be sliced back to a mere shell of what it was so that it would run on any machine. I can tell you, it runs very, very smoothly, but the detail is all still there. In fact, if I pan around my character's outfit there, you can see the individual stitching on the clothing. It is still incredible and one of the most graphically complex games in terms of MMOs that I've ever, ever played. It is gorgeous, absolutely fantastic. So if you've got any worries about what it looks like now, folks, allay those concerns because it looks a treat and I can't wait to show you the rest of the game. Anyway, we need to head on in here, and this will be, again, familiar to anyone who's joined us in our Let's Play version 1 series. Here we go, collecting rewards. Complete a quest by right-clicking the NPC with a check mark displayed above his or her head. Completing a quest will earn us a variety of rewards from items and gil to XP. And of course, we are interested in all of those. Let's head on over here, get straight into it, speak with Mother Mion and see what she's got to say. We will right click on her. Well, well, what have we here? She says. A wide-eyed and wondering young adventurer come to put your name down at the guild, I assume? I think you've assumed right, Mother. Welcome. Meone is my name, or Mother Meone as most call me, and the Carline Canopy is my place. As head of the Adventurers Guild in Gridania, I have the honour of providing guidance to the fledgling heroes who pass through our gates. No matter your ambitions, the Guild is here to help you attain them. In return, we expect you to fulfil your duties as an adventurer by assisting the people of Gridania. A fine deal, wouldn't you agree? To an outsider's eyes, all may seem well with our nation, but naught could be further from the truth. The people live in a state of constant apprehension. The Exile and various gangs of common bandits provide an unending supply of trouble, trouble compounded by the ever-present threat of the Galian Empire to the north, and that is to say nothing of the Calamity. Even now, the wounds have barely begun to heal, but I speak of it as if you were there, forgive me. 5 years past, Eorzea was well nigh laid to waste when a dread worm emerged from within the lesser moon Delamud and rained fire upon the realm. It is this which people call the Calamity. Scarcely a square melm of the Twelve's Wood was spared the devastation. Yet despite the forest's extensive wounds, not a soul among us can recall precisely how it happened. I am well aware of how improbable that must sound to an outsider. It is improbable, but it's also true. For reasons we can ill explain, the facts surrounding the Calamity are shrouded in mystery. There are as many versions of events as there are people willing to recount them. Yet amidst the hazy recollections and conflicting accounts, all agree on one thing: that Eorzea was saved from certain doom by a band of valiant adventurers. Whatever else we've misremembered, none of us have forgotten the heroes who risked life and limb for the sake of the realm. And yet, whenever we try to say their names, the words die upon our lips. And whenever we try to call their faces to mind, we see naught but silhouettes against a blinding glare. Thus have these adventurers come to be known as the Warriors of Light. Pray, do not feel daunted by the deeds of legends. We do not ask that you become another Warrior of Light, only that you do what you can to assist the people of Gridania. Great or small, every contribution counts. I trust you, you will play your part. All that's left then is to conclude the business of registration. Look, here's a quill. Scrawl your name right there. Oh, and I would appreciate it if you used your real name. There is a special place in the seventh hell for those who use amusing aliases. Seraphis Thrallwyn? And you're quite sure that that isn't an amusing alias? Oh, how rude. Very well. From this moment forward, you are a registered adventurer of Gridania. Nation blessed of the elementals and the bounty of the Twelve's Wood, the Guild expects great things from you. And look what just arrived, another goddamned adventurer. Don't you start with that. Adventurers are the very salve that Gridania needs. The Elder Seedseer herself bade us welcome them with open arms. Do you mean to disregard her will? Of course not. Lest you forget it, it is my sworn duty to uphold the peace. Am I to blame if outsiders bring mistrust upon themselves? You, adventurer, mind that you do not cause any trouble here, or I shall personally cast you out of this realm and into the seventh hell. Pay that outburst no mind. He meant only to counsel you. Suspicious characters have been prowling the Twelves Wood of late, you see, and the Wood Wailers feel they cannot afford to take any chances. As is often the way with folk who live in isolation, Gridanians are wont to mistrust things that they do not well know, your good self included. But fear not, however. Given a catalogue of exemplary deeds in no more than a handful of years, the locals will surely warm to you. On behalf of my fellow citizens, I welcome you to Gridania. May you come to consider our nation as your own in time. Now then, you may depend on old Mother Miune to teach you a few things that every adventurer should know. There we go, folks. Coming to Gridania, we have an opportunity now to complete this quest. And once again, if you hover over this, you can see we get 50 XP and we get ourselves 103 gil. All that remains for me to do is to complete this quest. And there we go. You can see that this concludes the introductory game tutorial. And in fact, if we click on that, you have taken the first step as an adventurer in the city of Gridania. Listen well to the wisdom of Mother Miune, and then go forth and discover the incredible adventures that await us. And you can see we've got a little bit of a tutorial there talking about the main scenario quests, and they are important quests used to tell the story of Eorzea and her people, and they are named main scenario quests. These tasks are easily distinguishable from the others by their unique icon. And you can see there that Mother Miune has one of those icons above her head. And you can see also that if I spin around, it looks a little bit empty in here. Yes, we have some NPCs, but we are not out in the real world yet. We're still in our introductory instance. However, if I click on this up here, Mother Miune, and start our actual storyline quest, pretty sure we're going to be sent out into the real world. We're going to hopefully hook up with some familiar faces from our community and our previous Let's Play series. I can't wait to do that. Mother, what have you got for us close to home? Mione, the proprietress of the Carline Canopy, wants you to perform 3 tasks that will help us learn the fundamentals of adventuring. Well, hey, I'm up for that. Let us begin at the beginning, shall we? Now that you're a formal member of the Adventurers Guild, we must be sure you have a firm grasp of the fundamentals of adventuring. To that end, I have 3 tasks that I wish you to perform. Your first task is to visit the Aetherite. The massive crystal stands in the middle of the Aetherite Plaza, not far from the Carline Canopy. As a device that enables instantaneous transportation, the Aetherite plays a key role in the life of the ever-adventuring wanderer. Once you have located the crystal, all you need to do is touch its surface. A member of the Wood Wailers will be present to offer further instruction. For your second task, you are required to visit the Conjurer's Guild. There is still no better place to learn the arts of conjury. Speak with Medel and she will explain the benefits of joining the guild. And of course, we're getting asked to go there because I chose Conjurer back at the character creation screen. For your third and final task, I would have you visit the markets at the heart of Old Gridania's commercial district. There you will find weapons, armor, and all the various items that an adventurer may need on her travels. There is, however, more to the markets than buying and selling goods. Speak with Passmontre and listen well to his counsel. Now, can I just say, folks, if you are watching along from home and thinking, what on earth is he saying? Look, this is my interpretation of these names, which seem to be steeped in French, so I'm going to put a bit of a French twist on them. Passmontre. Okay, no, I won't do that, but if I pronounce them wrong, I apologize up front. Speak with that person and listen well to his counsel. The Master Merchant can be, well, uncooperative at times, so be sure to offer him one of my famous eel pies. Like so many men, he is much more charitable when his stomach is full. Here we go, I made a batch not long ago. Well, you have your tasks, Seraphis. May Nofika guide your path. Ah, and one more thing. Should you happen to come across any citizens in need, don't be afraid to offer a helping hand. I'm certain they'll be pleased to meet an adventurer in whom they can confide their woes. Granted, the work they offer is unlikely to be of realm-shattering importance, but prove your worth and build a reputation, and in time, folk will be more inclined to entrust you with matters of moment. There we go. Quest has been accepted. And look at this, folks. It looks to me like we're out in the main world. Let's click on this main menu. The main menu grants quick and easy access to most of the game's main features. For example, selecting character opens a window containing your character's various attributes and currently equipped gear. Selecting journal displays a list of current and completed quests and leave quests. Don't worry, folks, we'll get into all of that much, much later. You can see here we've also got tutorials about key binding, HUD layout, system configuration, everything here. Again, we will go through that with the guys and gals from Distant World. Game progress, of course, is saved automatically. There's no in-game save or load functions. However, to prevent data from being lost or corrupted, it is strongly recommended that you end each playing session by logging out or exiting the game from the system menu. And of course, that is the same with every other MMO. You can see I've also got one here on navigation. Pressing M on your keyboard or clicking the map icon located in the main menu on the lower right hand corner, and this of course down here is the main menu, will bring up your area map. If a quest objective is located in that area, it will be indicated by a special icon. We'll talk more about that later. The location of the quest objectives can be also confirmed by clicking on the objective in the duty list. And again, this is the duty list under my minimap. You can see here I've got a couple of duties for the quest close to home. If I click on close to home, it brings up the journal. If I want, I can then click on map from there, and it's nice and easy. You can see it brings up three options that I've got here. If I click on one of them, for example, visit the Conjurer's Guild, that is the map for that particular step of the quest. Or I can click on it directly in my actual duty tracker down here. If I click attune yourself to the etherite found inside the city, it directly brings up the map. How good is that? That is exactly where it is. And again, if I zoom out enough, you can see where I am. This is my objective. It is up to the north. There are also icons on the map. By way of the legend, you can see where all of the functions and facilities are on the map, and it's great to see that. But right now, we need to head on up to the north. However, as you can tell, we're out in the real world. You can see now that it is a bustling area here. We've got players from all over the world logged into this Masamune server. Look over the back there. Can you see what I can see? I can see a cute little Lalafell sitting at a table. If I click on it, it is none other than our favorite little person, Katella Avonlea. Hello to you. Oh, look at that, joining a party. It's so good to see a familiar face. Hi, Katella.
Hello.
Oh, my Lord. I can't believe this. Welcome to Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. You know what? I'm a little bit lost. Even though all of this is familiar, there are certain things in here that I'm still struggling with. Is that normal for a new player?
Yeah. Anytime you're new to anything, right? It takes you a little bit.
Oh, it does. I mean, this one is kind of weird, though, because it's kind of familiar, but subtle little things are kind of different. So it's taken me a while to get my head around. You know what? We've got a help text here saying joining a party. So rather than go through the help text, I'm going to ask you, what happened then? Did you send me a party invite?
I did.
Okay, so what are the benefits of me being in a party? I mean, I can see you up the top there, and of course it means I can select us easily. But is there anything actually that happens to my stats if I join a party, or is it just something that's handy for adventuring together right now?
Well, it's handy right now because we can keep track of each other in this mess, but you do get stats for different people, and it looks like you're a conjurer.
I am a conjurer. Now, by the way, I chose conjurer when I decided to come into the game, and I was going to ask you, have I done something wrong? Because I'm not really a conjurer, but I really wanted to come here into Gridania, and as you know, the starting areas are now tied to classes, so have I really messed things up? Because I'm not really a conjurer.
Oh, but you are.
What do you mean?
You can be anything, remember? This is Final Fantasy 14.
Of course, I completely forget. All right, so what if I want to run around as a marauder, though? How would I do that?
Same as before. You would change and just put on on your axe, right?
But you know what? We can do that much later on. So for now, I'll just run around as a conjurer. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay, now look, I actually have a quest, Katella. I don't know if you know, but Mother over there has given me a quest, and the first thing I need to do is attune myself to an etherite found inside the city. Now, I'm pretty sure we're not in the city. We're in the Adventurers Guild right now, right?
Right.
So, do you know where on earth I have to go? I'm completely lost.
I do. Let's go.
All right. I can't believe you're here. Thank goodness for that. Oh, hang on. Before we go anywhere, how do I do emotes? Is there an emote window?
Yeah, down in the bottom lower right-hand corner.
Oh, here we go.
Second one from the right.
I found it.
I found emotes.
Oh, there's heaps of them. Okay, so hang on. If I click on you to select you and then... Hey! If I go click on bow... Ah, look at that. Okay, so the emotes are still in the game, folks. Here we go. Welcome! Welcome to Katella. In fact, I'm going to stand next to you. Hang on. I want to check out a couple of these. And look at that. Yes, clap. Yay! And what else have we got here? Bow. Oh, they're all here. Okay. Can I actually manually do these as well, or do I have to click on them in this window?
Oh, you can do a couple things. You can either type it, just do slash whatever.
Okay, so hang on, or, slash wave. Mm-hmm. Oh, you're right. Okay, yep.
Or if you have that emote list open, you can actually drag the word you want down to your hotbar, and then it'll make a little macro for you right there.
No way. Okay, I'm going to drag welcome down to my hotbar. Oh my lord! I did not know that! That is incredible. Okay, and let's drag down... You know I'm going to have a whole hotbar just dedicated to emotes, right?
Yeah, but before we do that, before we go too much more with the emotes, let's... So you had to get to the eighth ray, right?
That's right. That's right, I do. And I'm lost. So help!
Okay, let's head out this way.
Oh, look at this. So hang on. Are we actually going out into the real world now? This is the live game world.
Yeah. You're actually in the game world now. We're in Gridania.
This is amazing. Do you know what? I've got you selected. And thank goodness, because you've got a great big white thing over your head so that I can't lose you. Look how many people there are. Katella, you've been here since launch on day one. Have you been impressed with how many people are playing? I mean, we're in the early access period even. We're not even up and running full. How many people are... Has it been busy?
It's been crazy busy.
Well, it looks like there's people everywhere here. Hey, I've got a quest at Bernadette here. Is this the person I need to speak to, or do I need to go up to the Aetherite?
No, let's go ahead and go to the Aetherite for now.
Now, is this new? I do not remember this being here in version 1. In fact, this area that we're in right now was just a lake, wasn't it?
That's right.
Oh, so they've actually moved where the Aetherite crystal... Okay, so can I go up here? It's got one of those weird storyline symbols on it, Kat. Do I right-click on the crystal?
Yeah, you're going to right-click on it, and you're actually going to get a cutscene, just a small one.
Okay, all right, here we go. Let's see what happens. Greetings, adventurer. I see you are faithfully following Mother Mione's instructions. You better believe it. Allow me to offer you a bit of instruction myself. I am Nicia of the Wood Wailers, and I know a thing or two about the Aetherite. Yes, that big crystal right there. Aetherites are devices that tap into ethereal energies and are primarily used as a means to travel swiftly from one place to another. Return and teleport, the most common transportation spells, make direct use of the Aetherites and their connection to the flow of ether. And as these devices are found in almost every corner of Eorzea, any adventurer worthy of the name will wish to seek out and attune herself to each and every one. Truly, few things in this world are so useful to an intrepid explorer. But you need not locate them all at once. Before rushing out into the wilds, I suggest you start with the Aetherites found here in Gridania. Should you wish to learn more about the Aetherite or transportation magic, I am here to answer your questions. And there we go, return learned. So Katella, it says here that I've attuned to Aetherite and I'm now able to use the return spell. What on earth is
That's
that
right.
all about?
So if you're out in the wilderness and you just want to get back to Gridania, you can, well right now it's set to Gridania.
Right.
You would just hit that return and it'll bring you back here.
Okay, so is that on my, oh, okay. So next to the emotes icon down the bottom right hand there on my main menu, I've got a return button with a little picture of a house. Is that a spell?
Yeah, that's the spell. You can also get it from action and traits and bring it down to your hotbar if you really want, but you already have it on the mini mic.
Okay, great stuff. Oh, in fact, we can see a whole bunch of stuff in this window. Oh boy, we're going to be here for a long time if we get into this now, so we'll leave that till later. But can I just say, Katella, that the interface in A Realm Reborn is just a joy to use. It's smooth, it's familiar, and it's a world apart from the quirkiness of version 1, yeah?
Yeah, no, it's definitely a lot better.
Oh, it's very familiar, and I love it. All right, so I'm going down the duty tracker here, and I can see that the next thing we need to do is visit the Conjurer's Guild. But Katella, this is interesting. I am presented with a worldview map, and to be honest, it's a little bit confusing because it looks like my objective is out in the middle of the world somewhere, and I have no clue where I am or how to get there. Am I missing something?
So you can see that it's showing you that where Gridania is, right?
Yes.
And then it's showing you that your location that you want to get to is outside of Gridania.
Yes.
So go ahead and click on the point that it's showing you on the map, and it should open up.
It did. It did indeed. Oh, okay. So now I've... right. Okay. So let me have a look here. I'm panning around. Right now, is that because it's out of the current zone that we're in?
Yep.
Okay, all right. Look, I'm going to follow you. In fact, you know, is it easy? Can you leave your map open while you run around? Is that a good idea?
You can. Okay. Yeah, you can.
We might do that. We'll have a play around with the map and the objectives as we go. All right, Katella, I am in your hands as always. I'm going to get lost otherwise. My inner compass is not as great as yours. Are you able to lead us to the Conjurer's Guild?
Yep, just follow me.
All right, and again, folks, if you want to make sure you don't lose someone, select them, and you can see this great big white mark above their head, and that means I'm never going to lose Katella. And oh, it looks good. Look, we're at nighttime. It looks, oh, the stars are coming out, Katella. It looks absolutely gorgeous, the lighting. Look, how about you? What do you think of this graphic overhaul of the game? To my eyes, this is silky smooth and looks absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, no, it's great. I love it.
Oh, hey, now speaking of, hey, you just disappeared. Come back.
I did. You're walking through there.
Wait a minute. Wait. What is this? Do you know what this reminds me of? It looks like a zone line from Final Fantasy XII. And any of you guys who are Final Fantasy players will know exactly what I'm talking about. I'm not going near that. You just totally disappeared. What is that?
Come on through.
Okay. You know, I trust you, right? Here we go. And I'm going to hit backslash, which is walk. I'm going to walk through and close my eyes. And oh, I ran off. Gridania, old Gridania. Hey, is that... Hey, hello. Oh, hang on. I can select you and click on one of my... There we go. One of my... Oh, wow. Look at it. It's beautiful through here. Listen to the ambient sound. Okay, you have to tell me what just happened there. Is there zoning in this game now? Come on.
There is zoning in this game.
Oh, why? Why is there zoning?
Well, you noticed all the new little... Like how everything looks so alive.
Yeah.
And everything now. And that's quite different than what it was before, right?
Yeah. You can see actual players running around, like hundreds of them.
Yeah. And so for them to be able to do that... they kind of needed to be able to split the area up into zones.
Ah, okay. All right. So they have zoned it all off in favor of performance. I honestly thought that zoning in an MMO would be annoying, you know, that it would be, you know, lengthy loading screens, but it's actually very fast, isn't it? It's pretty seamless.
It's really quick and you get to watch yourself run off.
Yeah, which is neat. Okay. All right. So that's great. That means we can keep our frame rate nice and high and look at it, folks. Hey, by the way, the day-night cycle, it seems to have got dark relatively quickly. It's obviously not real time, Katella.
No. Okay. It's not real time.
That's a bit faster. That's kind of cool because that means in one play session, you get to sort of see a bunch of different times of day, presumably weather as well.
Yeah. Yeah, there's tons more weather than there used to be. I believe a day-night cycle, I don't know, we'll ask somebody as we go along, but I'm pretty sure that it's an hour.
Okay, there we go. Good stuff. All right, look, I'm going to stop and gawk at everything around here, so lead me on or else we'll never get where we need to go, which of course is the Conjurer's Guild. Oh, hang on. Now, if I open my map, and when you run, I just noticed that the map goes see-through as well. That's really handy. So you can actually leave it up. But I can see here we are, folks. In fact, if I click on it, there's us. And you can see as I move my character around, there's a direction. We are now in the zone that we need to be. And there is our close-to-home objective. All right, now, where did Katella go? Let's select her and see if we can find her. Where are you? Come back. You've left
come
me.
Back.
Oh, come back. Here you go. There we are. Oh, no way. Look who it is. We've stumbled upon... somebody. Oh, wow. It is none other than Blindrage Gallifrey who joins the party. I've got a joyous emotion just for you there. Hello, Blindrage.
Hello. How are you?
I'm awesome. I'm so good to see you. Let's give you a great big cheer. Welcome to Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. Unbelievable. You look just a little bit different than you did in the past. Oh, but you still got your silly dance. What is going on? That is amazing. Have you changed your character a little bit?
Yeah, decided I liked them better this way.
Okay, look, I'm going to come along and stand next to you. There we go. You know what? You're still huge. You're still massive. Don't sit on me, please. That is unbelievable. Good Lord. Now, come on. Give us an honest opinion. What do you think of the new graphics in Final Fantasy XIV?
I think they're great, actually.
For a blind person. Well, they look great from where I'm standing. Katella, are you happy with how Blind has remodeled himself?
Oh, yeah. No, I like his character. I liked it before, but I like this character, too.
Yeah, it looks really neat. I love the hair. You got feathers on your face there, on the end of your braids. You look amazing. By the way, what armor are you wearing, Blind?
Oh, this is just my Gellica, my first
You're level 7. So hang on, is that level 7 of the class that you are right now? Or is this the same Blind Rage or a different one?
No, it's the same one. It's just a different class.
Okay, there we go.
It's my Arcanist.
Okay, we'll give you a great big clap. Give you the clap there. There we go. All right, look, it's nice to see you. You can see that I'm just borrowing Katella, and she is taking me to the Conjurer's Guild. But we've come across you. What's that thing behind you over there?
That's a small Aetherite right over there.
Wait a minute. Okay, so I just clicked on a big one before. Is this...
Yeah.
Well, hang on, what's this got to do with the price of fish? How does this work?
This teleports you around the city faster.
Okay, so is this like a small version of the big one out there?
Yeah.
Okay, so what do I have to talk to it or something? What do I do?
You just right-click on it and attune yourself to it.
Right-click. Oh, it says attuning. Oh, hey, nothing bad's going to happen. Am I going to get whisked off?
You're going to blow up.
Ah!
Okay, it's no big deal.
Hey, wait a minute. You now have Ethernet? Access to the Ethernet? Really? Quick travel?
Yeah, you can get on Google now.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Ethernet. Very funny. Quickly travel throughout the city, and you can do that by simply placing your hand upon Ethernet shards. That is amazing. Hang on. I've got a help menu. We don't need that. We've got Blind Rage. So, hang on. Blind, how can I use these in the future? What happens if I right-click on it now?
Well, you can teleport.
Okay, hang on. Here we go. Oh, current location. Oh, so I can go back to the main Aetherite plot. Hang on a minute. If I'm thinking right, and I'm smart, so I must be. Does that mean there's going to be more of these around the city?
Yeah, there's all in each one of the cities. There's a whole bunch of them, and then you can go to different like camps and stuff and get them too.
So this is a fast travel option for the city. In other words.
Yeah, something like that. It's like a subway system.
It is, isn't it? Hang on, if I open my map, it appears on the map as well. And in fact, I can see the little icons. So Katella, were these in version 1 of the game? I don't remember them, I don't think.
I didn't use them very often because they were pretty expensive to use. They did have them, but you bought them off the black market or with company seals.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, then definitely I never used them. And... Hey, Blind Rage, what are you doing? Is that a trade?
Yes, I got presents for you.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, you know what? Seraphis has one thing to say about that, and that is that she cheers. What on earth are you going to be giving me? And by the way, my inventory is 95 out of 100, so I can see that legacy has followed me over. But don't tell anyone, okay, Katella? Okay. Don't tell anybody at all.
So you got 3 spots, right?
I have definitely got 3 spots at the moment, yes.
Okay, here comes your presents.
I like presents. Oh, what's this? Hang on, I'm hovering over them. A mammoth whistle, a wayward hatchling whistle, and a cherry bomb whistle. I have no idea. What do I do? Do I hit trade?
Yep.
Okay,
yep.
Here we go. Oh, okay. Hit trade. Complete the trade. Yes, let's get rid of the map. Okay, 2 slots remaining in your... Oh, it tells you now. Okay, hang on. What have you just done? Let's go over here if you don't mind. Because there's trees in the way. Come and see me over here. How do I get at these things?
Okay, see this little boat that's right beside me right here?
Yeah.
It's wind-up airship?
Yeah.
That's the new pet system. Minion system.
Really?
Yeah,
it's like a companion.
Yeah, it's one of those.
Okay.
So if you learn those, then you can call them.
Hang on. Okay, so I'm going to go into my inventory, and I'm going to cycle through all of these pages. Don't look, folks. Don't look about how crowded and busy it is. Okay, so Katella, I can see that he has deposited in my inventory a mammoth whistle, a wayward hatchling whistle, and a cherry bomb whistle. What do I do with these?
Right-click on them and use them.
Right-click. Wow, the interface is so much... Whoa, look at that! Ah! The interface is so much easier now. Okay, I'm going to right-click. Yeah, use all of them. Cherry bomb, and there we go. I've used all 3. Wait a minute. Hey, Blind. This is Catella's fault. They've disappeared. They've gone.
It's okay.
It's okay. Just go to your actions and traits.
Okay, hang on a minute. Actions and traits. Still getting used to where all these are. There we go. Nice. Bottom row. Yes, I'm there.
Okay, so go down to minions.
Oh, there we are, minions. Oh, hey, I've got 3 minions. Hang on, let me guess. Can I drag them to my hotbar?
That's right.
Yep. Okay. Drag them to your hotbar.
Hang on, 1, emotes. You know, my entire hotbar is going to be full of emotes and minions, Katella. You know that, right?
I know that. And your mounts are in there.
Are they? Oh, really? Oh,
yeah, the mounts are right above the minions.
Ooh, I'm pretty sure. Do I have
when
mounts
when you get them.
Oh, when I get them. Okay, so hang on. If I click on one of these, let's say a wayward hatchling.
There he is.
Oh, no way. I've got a cute little chocobo. He's busting out of his shell. That is the cutest thing ever. Oh, my God. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Blind. You've given me the first presents that I've ever received in Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. And I thank you, Cal. Can I click on these other ones? What's a mammoth? Let's have a look. Click on him. And there he is. Oh, no. I think I made him disappear again. Come back.
See, he's right behind you.
Oh, he's cute. So cute. Hang on. What is... So you click on them again to dismiss them. And here we go. A cherry bomb. Hey.
He's behind you, too.
That's like a little miniature version of... Isn't that the ones that the Thaumaturge... Oh, look, I don't know what I'm talking about. All I know is that they look awesome and cool. So we've got little pets already. Thank you, Blind Rage. That is, can I leave this out, Katella, my little cherry bomb?
Yep, leave it out and let's get going into the Conjurer's Guild.
Okay, hey, Blind, you going to come with us?
Yeah, I'll come.
Good stuff. All right.
I might run into walls and stuff.
That's okay. It's like the old family is being reunited. This is so much fun. And look at these graphics here. Do you know what? I think in the meantime that we've cycled through to daytime, perhaps. I'm not sure. Anyway, look at this. The familiar sights and sound of a guild. This is indeed the Conjurer's Guild. And look who is waiting for us here. It is none other than that archer extraordinaire, our good old mate, Merik. G'day.
Hello.
Do you know what? This is your fault, I think. You have caused something to happen. I've got all sorts of things coming up on the screen, and perhaps you can tell me, Merik. Firstly, it came up and said that we have a light party. What does that mean? That we're all light bulbs?
No, not quite. A light party means that you have a party of four members.
Okay, so does that have any effect on our abilities in the game?
If you're fighting, yes, the size of your party does have a little impact on your fighting. It actually helps a little bit.
Okay, well, that's good. All right, well, I'm glad that you made us a light party. You can see here, folks, I've also got a helper tutorial pop-up called Limit Break. And don't worry, we will cover that off later. For now, I'm just excited to get the old gang together. So, Merik, I'm at some kind of guild here. What is a Conjurer's Guild? And I presume if I was an archer, I'd be at an archer's guild or whatever. Why am I being sent here?
Well, you're a conjurer, so most likely you're being sent to the Conjurer's Guild.
Yeah, okay, that makes total sense. So, if you excuse me for one moment, I'm just going to talk to the guild receptionist here because she's got one of those funny storyline icons above her head. And no doubt she's going to have something to say. You seek the secrets of Conjury, adventurer, then search no longer, for you have found your way to the Conjurer's Guild. Well, actually, to be honest, I didn't find my way. It was all Katella. But anyhow, it is at Mion's request that you have come. Then allow me to provide you with an overview of what it is to be a conjurer. Conjury is the art of healing and purification. Its practitioners harness the power of nature that they might bring about change in the form of spells. Primitive magic, such as once wrought by individuals known as mages, meaning those with the ability to manipulate ether, has existed since the dawn of time. It was not until some five centuries ago that conjury emerged from this shapeless agglomeration of spells and charms, an event which led to the founding of Gridania. In those dark days, the elementals would not suffer man's presence in the Twelves Wood, forcing our forebearers to make their homes beneath the earth, in the great subterranean city of Galmora. But their desire to settle in the Twelves Wood continued to burn fiercely. Time and time again, they sought to curry the elementals' favor. Unlike men and other creatures bound in the temples of flesh, the elementals are of pure ether. Recognizing this, the mages of old reasoned that their talent for etheric manipulation might allow them to commune with those enigmatic entities. It took five long decades, but our forebears finally succeeded. Their reward? The elementals' permission to dwell here in the Twelves Wood. And so it was that the nation of Gridania was born. I can begin your initiation whenever you desire. Call upon me when you are ready to take the first step. And there we go. Visit the Conjurer's Guild has been ticked now. Katella, she's got an exclamation mark above her head. We don't want to do that just yet, though, do we? We're sticking to our close-to-home quest.
That's right. If it says that you are done with this section of the close-to-home quest, then you're good.
We are Oh my lord. Blindrage, that didn't take you long to get into your big white undies? Good lord, man. Must say, you are a little bit dark. Have you been out in the sun? Have you been suntanning in the break?
In the break.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have. Yeah, oh my lord. It was Dalinwood. Hey, you've got a big tattoo on your back. That looks awesome. Is anyone ever going to explain to me what that is? Or can I get one?
No.
You can get one, but we'll probably talk about it a little later.
All right. Look, Merik, it's great to see you. Can I just get a very brief opinion from you? What are your thoughts about the new client and A Realm Reborn?
Well, the client is definitely a lot smoother than 1.0 was, that's for sure.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. And if you ask me, it's a lot more familiar. You're a player of many MMOs. Of course, you're in Rift, you're in Guild Wars, you played some SWTOR. You name it, you've been there. It's nice to see a familiar UI, don't you think?
Yes, definitely it is.
Yeah, it really, really is. All right, Katella, I have one more task in my close-to-home quest here, and that is to listen to Passmontre's explanation of the markets. Does that mean I have to head to the marketplace?
Yeah, maybe we'll follow Merik out there.
Okay, Merik, are you a shopaholic? Can you take me shopping, basically?
I could take you shopping, but I'm not a shopaholic.
Right, sure you're not. All right, I'm going to follow you. And may I add, Merik, that you look fantastic there. Is that a Moogle on the top of your bow?
Shh. Yes.
You nasty, nasty person. Now, hey, Blindrage, how many goats have been slain since you've been here in A Realm Reborn?
Four. I haven't found any yet.
You haven't found any goats? Thank goodness, say all the goats. Do you know what?
I think
you probably slaughtered them all in version one and there were none left. This is another one of those zone. Are you going to send me through that, Merik?
Yes, we're going to go back through this zone.
I'm going to throw you through it.
You get thrown. Ah! Okay, I'm running ahead. I'm way ahead of you. It is really neat, by the way, how you run through that zone line. And there we go. What was that? 2 or 3 seconds. Let me open up my map now and take a look at where we are. There's where we are. And where is my objective? You know what, Katella? I'm going to have to click on it. Listen to the explanation. Oh, it's in this old Gridania thing again. So it's obviously not in this zone. If we click it. Oh, okay. So that's over the other side. Okay, Merik, I hope you know where you're going.
I do. We're taking a shortcut.
Okay. All right. Good stuff. And look at it, folks. Here we are. This is what Gridania looks like in broad daylight. It is absolutely glorious. It is a fantastic sight here. Look at the shadows. Look at the bright colors. This game is absolutely incredible. It looks amazing, and it is running like a song here on my machine. I'm getting a full 60 frames per second. Square Enix, whatever you have done, good on you, because it looks a treat and it performs just as well. All right, Merik, I have no idea where you're taking us, but I have all my faith in you. What do you think of the, like this, of course? You would have spent a lot of time in Gridania here back in version 1.0. What are your thoughts about this new version? Do you love it or do you hate it?
I actually like the new Gridania.
Yeah, it's cool, isn't it? It does look very different. It's not as, well, I don't know, it's not as dark and foreboding. And here we go through another line. You can see Katella heading on through there. It's not as dark and foreboding as the original one was, but I kind of like it. And hey, we haven't seen it in full night yet, so that's okay. All right, where are we? Let's have a look on the map here. Gonna open it. Oh, hang on a minute. We are just to the south of where we need to go. I can see Ebony Stalls, the Rosewood Stalls, and the Shaded Bough. And there is my quest close to home. So thank you, Merik. You've taken us right to where we need to go. Now, I'm just going to make sure my cherry bomb is still out. Yes, it is. All right, so is this the marketplace? Is that where we're headed?
This is the marketplace, yes.
Okay, so there's a board over there. Where are we headed? Now, I need to go and find... Now, I'm looking for someone called Passmontre to get an explanation of... Who's that waving at me? Oh, my lord! Look who it is! It is Picoman! Oh, man, the family is coming together now. Hello, Pico!
Hey, Sandra.
Oh, my lord. You know, another familiar face. Oh, I must admit, I'm a little bit lost, Pico. I'm getting a bit freaked out here because there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people around here. Is that to be expected? I mean, we haven't even launched the game yet. It is early access. Did you expect this to be as busy as it is?
Well, I had faith in your CP, and it looks like a lot of other people have as well.
Yeah, I think so. And can I just ask, you obviously had faith. Do you think he delivered?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
All right, so you're happy with the new client. What about the new UI? I mean, it's very familiar. If you've played Rift or WoW or EverQuest or anything like that, this is going to be very familiar to you. Do you like the way it's gone, the new direction, or do you prefer the old quirky menus of version 1.0?
Oh no, it's really nice to have a proper grown-up UI now.
It is a grown... Hey, by the way, did you notice I've got a little companion over there? I bet you don't have a companion. I got given a cherry bomb by Blindrage, who's standing right next to us. Have you got any companions yourself?
I've got a little one hidden behind me right now.
Oh, what a goblin. Oh, okay. So already you're miles ahead of us. I have no doubt that you've either crafted that or had some hand in making that. We'll talk about that another time. But what are you doing here? And where are we exactly?
Well, this is where I come to do some shopping and the market boards over here.
Hang on, so market board. What's a market board?
Well, if you remember in 1.0, we episode 21 of the old Let's Play, you went into a market ward.
Yeah.
And it was filled with NPCs and stalls of and that was the time that you picked up some goods off my old retainer.
Oh yes, so hang on, this is where all the retainers were, and I think you set us up an actual store. Was that the one?
Yeah.
Right, I remember
and
that, yeah.
You've really streamlined it and simplified it, so all you have to do now is right-click on this board.
Oh, what? Oh, so we don't actually have to go into a separate area?
Nope.
Okay, now I'm sure that we'll explain this in detail. In fact, there's the markets tutorial has come up. But just for now, let's just say, I guess, Pico, you no longer have to zone into a separate area with retainers. You can click on the market board, and is it pretty much like browsing an auction house?
Exactly, yeah.
Okay, so it's a lot more like WoW or Rift in that respect. You know what? That alone, to my mind anyway, is going to encourage me to utilize it a whole lot more, because to be honest, the old way of doing it was just a little bit painful. Wouldn't you agree, Pico?
Oh, yeah. And especially in its original incarnation, where you actually had to check each individual retainer for the item you wanted.
Yeah, which is just actually, in hindsight, ridiculous, isn't it? Okay, look, we'll close this down for now, but thank you for showing me. Let's have a look on the map, folks, just so you can see exactly where we are. There we are on the map. We're in this market area, which is over to the, well, it's below the East Shroud exit there, and we are over to the southeast, and this is where the actual market board is. But I can also see around here, Pico, there are a whole bunch of gold bag icons. Does that mean there are actual shops here as well?
Yeah, there's some NPC shops here where you can buy some basic goods.
Okay, all right, that's handy. So I remember that being similar in version 1.0 as well. Oh my lord, look who it is. It is some other familiar. Did you sneak up on me there? Hello, lady. It's so good to see you. How are you?
Hello, Sambo. It's been a while.
It's been a long, long while. What on earth are you doing here?
Oh, no, I'm just checking the market wards, and then I stumbled upon you.
Oh, God, you look amazing. Look at your outfit. In fact, I think you've got the big version of what Katella's. Okay, so you're a big fan of the market board as well, then?
Yeah, definitely. It's much better than it was in 1.0.
It sure is. Can I ask you, and I don't mean to interrupt your shopping, but it's so good to see you. We're bringing the family back together. Can I ask you, what are your initial thoughts about this revamp of Final Fantasy XIV? Do you like the UI? Are you a fan of the new graphics? How's it running on your computer?
Oh, it's amazing. It's so much beautiful. Like, it's different from when 1.0 used to be. Like, 1.0 was a great game in and of itself, in my opinion, but 2.0 is a whole different game, and it's taken my breath away.
It's, you know,
each
what?
New area.
I am exactly the same. Every time I see an area, my jaw hits the ground. I also can't believe just how incredibly smooth the game runs, and it looks amazing still. I mean, look at Pico, the detail there. Over there, we've got Merik. It looks just as good as it did in version 1, and Lady, like I said, you look absolutely fantastic. Now, did you make any tweaks to your character coming in? Because you would have been a legacy character as well, right?
Definitely. I did make a few small changes. It was a lot more difficult than I had originally planned it to be for me. But overall, just she's the same. Just
That's the lady. That looks like late. In fact, you know what? If you don't mind, I'm going to come over and deselect you so my head turns. I would like to get a photo. In fact, look, Merik, you're standing behind us. Do you want to come and join us? There's Katella. Come on over. And Pico as well. Come on. This is our first shopping trip. And the old family, the old gang is getting back together. There we go. Now, can somebody please tell me? I assume that Katella, to take a screenshot, I hit print screen, right?
That's right.
Okay, here, let's give that a go.
Do you want the UI in it? You can do scroll lock and then print screen.
Wait. What? Merik, did you hear that?
Yeah.
What's she going on about?
If you hit the scroll lock key, the UI will disappear and all you'll have is just a picture.
Wait a minute. I'm looking on... I don't see a scroll lock option on
your keyboard?
Oh, on my physical keyboard. Wow. Okay, hang on. Scroll lock. Hey, it all disappeared. Oh, that looks... Oh, look at this. It's the fam... Hang on. Print screen. Oh, that is awesome. There you go, folks. Some great advice. The scroll lock key on your keyboard will remove the UI. Fantastic. In fact, I'm going to slash cheer for that one. Oh, boy. All right, lady. Thanks for joining us. And oh, you have. You've joined us in the party. Will you stick with us as we go through my first quest here? Because I'm actually on my way to talk to an NPC here about an explanation of the markets. Do you want to hang around with us?
Definitely. I was actually going to ask what you were up to.
Yeah. Well, and of course, this is the great thing about an MMO. You bump into friends, old and new. And of course, we can join up and do all sorts of activities and have lots of fun online together. And you are more than welcome, lady. All right, look, I need to just pop over here. So I've got a quest that I need to hand in. It's one of my storyline quests. Oh, boy. So look at this. We've got Pico. We've got Katella. We've got Blindrage. We've got Merik. And now we've got Lady. I don't think it's going to get any better than this. Let's have a chat with Passmon Trey here and see what they've got to say. By what right does a fledgling adventurer presume to address Passmon Trey, master of the markets? Oh, I see they haven't lost their attitude in A Realm Reborn. You think you can stroll in here, bold as please, and demand my hard-earned knowledge? Ha! A merchant does naught for naught, especially when dealing with would-be heroes. If, on the other hand, you had some tasty morsel to curry my favour, then I might reconsider your request. Come now, this whole encounter reeks of Mione's handiwork, and more specifically, her baking. Don't look surprised, lass. I smelt that eel pie of yours a mile away. Hand it over. Oh, more. Okay, there's no fooling this guy. Here's a tutorial for handing over items, but you know what? I'm going to dismiss that. Lady, you've joined us now. I'm sure you can help me out here. I've got a couple of windows open. One says key items, and another says item request. What's going on?
So what you're going to do is, since he's asking for a pie, you're going to click on the pie from your inventory or right-click on the empty spot in that request box, and you'll pull up the item that you need, and you can drag it into the request box for the NPC to take from you.
Wow, okay, so the UI has become really intuitive now, hasn't it? Let's right-click on the handmade eel pie. Oh, handover. That's exactly what you said, and it fills the window. There it is. I can click handover, and there we go. Looks like something is happening. That flaky crust. Just divine. Very well, I'm a man of my word. Pay close attention, for I shall only explain this once. Hello, hello. The aspiring adventurer need look no further than the Rosewood and Ebony stalls. Both are but a short stroll from where we stand. If you mean to do battle, you'll be best prepared with a quality set of weapons and armor. Such goods are the province of the Rosewood stalls, directly south of here. You will be pleased to learn that the merchants of Gridania are exceedingly particular when it comes to craftsmanship, so you needn't fear defective straps and the like. If it's potions and paraphernalia that you seek, however, head north to the Ebony stalls. And it looks like that is them. The shelves there are lavishly stocked by widely travelled Ul'dah merchants, and I may truly say that I've seen things amongst their myriad wares that I scarce knew existed. Do you follow me thus far? The first step in any purchase is to select the stalls that meet your needs. Then you may concern yourself with price and profit. There is little more I can teach you with mere words. Go peruse the stalls and see for yourself what wares they offer. There is no substitute for first-hand experience after all, and I am wary of talking. Well, unless you have another eel pie. I'm sorry, we don't have another eel pie, but boy am I hungry. Listen to that. There we go. Listen to Passmontre's explanation of the markets. He has a quest for us further, but right now that is it for us. Katella, I'm done. That's it. The close to home quest says that I need to report to Mione in the Carline Canopy. Now, I'm guessing now that I've opened up a few of these Ethernet crystals, are we going to be able to get there very quickly, or is it nearby anyway?
Yeah, we should be able to do that, or we can run back either way.
Okay, all right. So I'm looking for you guys to lead me the way, because I'm going to get lost otherwise. Katella, I'm on you, and it looks like everyone's running this way. Whew, boy, there is so much information that we need to take in here, and we're only just on the cusp of it all. We're just at the tip of the iceberg, so to speak. But don't worry, folks. We will be covering off everything in great detail throughout the course of our series, just like we did in our version 1 Let's Play series. All right, so we zoned through here very quickly. Oh, is that the Carline Canopy I can see off in the distance, Pico? Yeah, it's the Etherite Crystal. Yeah. All right, so look, Pico, by the way, speaking of which, I just want to stop here for one moment. The Etherite Crystal has moved to, what I think is a better location. Are there any other major changes? Like, if you played in version 1, are you still going to be able to get around okay? Are the changes only minor, or is it completely revamped?
It's completely revamped. Everything's a lot more convenient, and they've really put in some thought of where they placed certain things like ethernets and fairies and other things.
Okay, that's good. I like that, because sometimes it was a bit hard to get around. Hi, lady. There you are over the background. Come on, come down with us, and let's see if I can have another chat with Mione, because, of course, she's the one that I need to hand in to. Look at this. It looks absolutely beautiful, and there's a bit of a haze off in the distance down there. Oh, man, I can't wait to get out there and adventure. But in the meantime, we need to come in here and speak with Mother Mione, and let's do just that. The conquering hero returns. Have you completed my little tasks? The three locations you visited will feature prominently in your life as an adventurer. It is best to grow familiar with them as soon as possible. And you took the time to listen to the woes of the citizenry? I cannot emphasize enough how important it is to lend your talents to one and all, no matter how trivial the matter may seem. I am thankful that you are an obliging sort, Seraphis. It is adventurers like you who will win the hearts of the locals and pave the way for those who follow. I pray Gridania can only rely on your aid in its struggles to come. And there we go. Look at this. We've got ourselves a quest completion dialogue close to home. We will complete that. Quest is complete. That's our first major storyline quest that has been done. And there we go. You can see that Mother Mione now has another quest in our major storyline. But you know what? Katella, forgive me, but I'm kind of itching to get outside, to be honest. Like, oh, we can do these quests at any time, right? We don't have to do them right now.
We don't have to do them right now.
Right,
no.
Look, I'm going to spin around, because all I want to do is go outside and... Hey, there's another familiar face. Look who it is. It is Clax. Hello, sir. How are you?
Hello, Samuel. I'm doing fine. How are you doing?
I'm great. I'm buzzing here. I'm so excited being in Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. You know what? We're used to seeing you in our World of Warcraft Let's Play series. Were you ever a version 1 Final Fantasy player?
Yes, but I only played like the last 2 months before they shut down the server.
Ah, okay. So no doubt you've been hanging out for this moment. Congratulations on getting in with early access. Can't believe we're all here. You look fantastic. Go on, tell us, what is your class right now?
I'm a gladiator.
A gladiator. You're a little person gladiator indeed. Can I just get a quickie from you? Are you loving this game, or have you come across problems that you're not happy with?
No, I just love it.
You love
100%.
It? 100%. Right, there you go. Easy as that. You know what? Join the rest of us. Join the club in our party here. We are loving it as well. But you know what, Clax? We've been doing quests all day. I've been taken through cutscenes. I've got to be honest. I really, really just want to get out and see the open world. Is that possible for me right now, or am I going to have to wait until we work our way through the storyline quest more?
Well, I have an idea. Why don't we go visit the East Shroud?
The East Shroud? The East Shroud from version 1? Can we get there already?
Yeah.
Okay, look, I am your humble servant. Please take me to the East Shroud right now. If that means we can get out into the open world, I am all for it. So I'm going to follow you. I've got you selected. You've got a white marker above your head. And Katella, how cool, how cute are the little people now? You happy with them?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my Lord. Oh, and it's raining. It's raining. Katella, you were talking about weather, and I think you mentioned earlier that the weather effects in the game are plenty. Have you seen a wide range of weather so far?
Oh, yeah. Like, thunder and lightning, I'm actually really impressed with.
Oh, no way. I hope I get to see it all. But right now, it's raining, and hopefully we're not going to get too wet. Looks like we're running through another one of these zones. You know what? It's going to take me a little while to get used to them, but I've got to say, they are nowhere near as annoying as I thought they would be when I first read about them. They're really no bother at all, are they? I mean, it's absolutely incredible. Okay, now, Clax, you know that I am trusting you totally here. I have no idea where we're going, right?
Neither do I, but follow me.
Okay. Following you through the market wards here. Now, lady, I hope you're still with us there. You were obviously a big player in version 1.0. Has everything that happened to you in version 1 carried across? Like, all your items were still there in your bags and, you know, all your quests and stuff? Like, how does it work? Are you able to pick up basically where you left off, or are you having to start all over?
Basically, we get all our items back, but a lot of the things that we had before aren't really usable anymore. The quests we had before are no longer existent, and it's pretty much a new game for each new player and each person.
Okay.
It doesn't matter if you played 1.0, it's a completely just a new adventure for you to share with the new players who do come into 2.0.
Right, but I guess you've still got all of that history from version 1 that you can draw upon. Mm-hmm. And look at this, we appear to have stopped here. By the way, it's still raining, and look at the sky. Look at the clouds up there. They are actual rain clouds. Merik, the detail is insane. Will those clouds change back if it's like a white, fluffy cloud, blue sky day, or do they always stay grey like that?
Oh no, they'll change.
Wow. The attention to detail, I see, Square Enix, has not been lost on you, and I thank you for that. Oh my lord. Oh my lord, you guys snuck somebody into the party. Look who it is. It's my favorite little black mage. Oh my lord, it's Seyo Meyo. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Oh, it's so good to see you. Oh man, I'm so glad that you made the transition over here. We're really completing the family now. Gosh, how long has it been since we've been together in game? Must be since what? Version 1 all those months ago? 9 or 10 months ago?
We've been together since last February.
Wow, that is unbelievable.
February of 2012.
Oh, it's so good to see you here. Unbelievable. Look, come on. I've asked everybody else, what are your thoughts about the game? Do you love it or do you loathe it?
So I started the beta and I almost immediately started crying because it was so good.
Woohoo! There you go. All right. High praise indeed. And by the way, you will be able to answer this question for me. When you joined the party just then, it said something about a full party. So I presume we've upgraded ourselves from a light party, right?
Yeah.
What is the difference between a light and a full party? Is it cosmetic or is there actually some functional benefit?
Well, it's just like any other MMO. You have content where you need a certain amount, like, you know, like light is for people in the game and full party is 8 people. So, I mean, there's content for both.
Okay, good to know. Well, look, I'm sure we'll find out all about that later on. Clax has led us here. Where are we? We're at some kind of gate. What's going on here? Who can help me out?
We're at a furry. There's definitely some people waiting for us outside, so might want to get out there.
So this is a... There you go. Here come. Come on, ferryman. Little ferryman. Where is he? There he is. Okay, so we're still in Gridania then. We're not actually outside. Is that the way I read it, Seyo?
Yeah.
Okay, so I can see there's a ferry skipper here, but hang on, I just want to run over here. We're on a pier. Oh, so this literally is like the boat in and out of Gridania. Is that a fair way of saying it?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Okay, this is really cool. I don't remember this in version 1.0. Maybe, I don't know if it was here or not, but if it was, I never got to it. But this is really cool. All right, so Clax, do I need to have a chat to the ferry skipper?
Thunder and lightning!
What? What, really? Is there thunder and lightning?
Yeah, thunder and lightning!
Wait, what? Thunder and lightning? No. No, I can see rain. Whereabouts are you?
I took the ferry.
Oh, you're ahead of us already.
I went fishing.
You've been fishing. Oh, you know what? I hope there's fishing in the game. Don't tell me, but I really hope there is. And if there is, we're going to spend a lot of time doing that. Trust me. All right. Hey, everyone's disappearing. Who can help me? What's going on here? Clax?
Clax? Yeah, you need to talk to the ferry skipper.
Oh, of course. Okay, here we go. Right click on the ferry skipper. I happen to be heading across the lake to Sweet Bloom Pier. Oh, in the East Shroud. So hang on a minute. Clax, that's outside, isn't it? That's truly outside of the city?
Yes, it's across the lake.
Okay, let's do it. Here we go. Board the ferry to Sweet Bloom Pier. Is that where we need to go? Is that going to take us to the East Shroud, Katella?
Yeah, should.
Okay, here we go. Click on yes, and looks like we're getting ourselves a cutscene. There we go. The Black Shroud, the East Shroud, and hopefully we are now going to be out in the world proper. Oh my lord, what is going on here? Look at what I have stumbled upon. It is a huge crowd of people. Let's get rid of this help text here. It looks to me like none other than Distant World. Hello, folks. Are you there? Oh my god, Katella, did you know that that was going to happen? Possibly. Oh my lord, this is absolutely incredible. My computer is struggling to render just how many of you guys are out here. Pico, do you really reckon there must be at least 100 people here? What do you think? This is incredible. I can't believe it. There are so many familiar names and faces here. Look at that right on the end. It is Shiveria Moonrunner. G'day, Shiv.
Hey, Jambo, how are you?
I'm overwhelmed right about now. I've been excited to have a couple of our old family members in my party running around through this episode. And now look at this. It is the entire Distant World family. I can see Exotica over there. G'day, XO.
How are you, Jambo?
I'm very well. Great to see you. And look at that up the back. It is Rusty Rastia. Hello, Rust.
Hi.
Oh, it's great to see you. Hey, Rust, I've been dying to hear from you. And look, I can see the thunder and lightning going off in the background. Quickly, please tell me, do you like the game or do you loathe it?
I like the storm right now.
Yeah, I love the storm right now as well. You know what? I can see Shaden up there as well. G'day, Shaden.
Hello.
Great to see you doing a jig. What do you think? Are you impressed with the new client?
Yes, absolutely.
It's unbelievable. Oh my God, what is over here? Katella, what is this? Are these mounts? What's going on? I can see two great big black mounts of some description. What are they?
Yeah, those are Magitek.
Okay, we're going to have to spend a whole episode on that. I have no idea what Magitek is, but all I know is that I love it. It looks incredible, as does Blindrage. The weather, you are 100% correct about the lightning. It looks amazing, doesn't it?
Told you.
It is incredible.
I can see flashes.
Yeah, I thought there was something wrong with my graphics card, but it's the lightning flash. Look at that. We've got chocobos bouncing up and down. This is unbelievable. We've got hundreds and hundreds of distant world folk right here, right now. I can already see Jenna Blossom. G'day, Jenna.
Hello.
Oh, tell me you're enjoying the new game, are you?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, this is absolutely incredible. I reckon that we're putting the entire server to a stress test just by being here right now. Hey, Katella, by the way, I noticed whenever we're in the presence of our fine distant world folk or any large number of people, is it just me or can I hear a whole lot of voices?
Yeah, that's something new that they added to 2.0.
That is incredible. It really makes you feel like you're in a crowded area. And look at this. Someone that is very special to me, that is one of our Alliance members over on Moogle. That would be none other than Whisper Greentop. And don't worry, folks, you'll be getting to see a lot more of him and the wonderful folk over on Divine Phoenix on the Moogle server, which is one of our partner Alliance servers. And we'll explain more about that in the upcoming episodes. But it's good to see you, Whisper, and thanks for coming and joining us here. Seyo Meyo, I can see you're surrounded by little people there. What's in your heart and mind right about now as you see the crazy shenanigans that's going on? Did you really think there'd be such a big turnout for our very first day here in Eorzea?
You know, I actually did. I mean, you'll remember this morning, we were all being excited at the functional, and we kind of gathered at the Yeah, it's sort of the adventure show in Gridania at 5 a.m. to kind of ring in 2.0, so...
That's right. I mean, there were hundreds and hundreds of people on there. In fact, Katella, can you tell me once again, I mean, we're going to be forming a free company. Presumably, we're going to run through all of that stuff in episodes coming up. Or am I a part of it? Like, how do I get in on this?
Let's see if we can do something about that right now.
Because I can see all these folk have DW after their name, and I'm kind of feeling a little bit left out. I don't think I belong to that, do I?
We shall take care of that for you.
Awesome. Oh, look at this. You have been invited to the free company called Distant World. Now, you can see here we've got an explanation coming up of exactly what free companies are, but we'll leave that for a future episode as well. But I guess an overview, Katella, is a free company a guild in other games?
It is.
All right, there we go. So effectively, I'm being invited to the Distant World Guild, except the Distant World free company invite. Yes, please. Now, can I play? Woohoo! There we go. Congratulations. I'm now part of that. Can you please tell me, how do I bring up the screen that shows me how many we have in our free company?
Okay, so in the right-hand lower corner where the mini menu is?
Yes.
See the one with all the little squares?
Yep. Oh, free company.
Click on that.
There we go. Opening it up. Now, how do I tell how many members we have?
Go ahead and click on the members tab, or members list.
There we go. Members. Hang on a minute. It is telling me that we already have 316 registered members in the Distant World Free Company. Is that some kind of error because it's day one?
Nope, that's not an error.
Okay, I am absolutely gobsmacked. It's also telling me that there are currently 169 members online right now as I talk. Are you kidding me? 169 people. They're probably all right here in the East Shroud. That is unbelievable. I cannot believe this. What a way to start off our Let's Play series. What a way to start off our brand new community here on Masamune in Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. Look at this, folks. What you are looking at now is Distant World in the background. And of course, we are never going to have time to say hello to each and every single one of them individually right now. But as I go up and down the path, let me put my walking mode on. There we go. You can see a lot of familiar names and faces there. And I am staring at a mumble symbol list that is so long it won't even fit on my screen, Katella. Have you ever seen so many people in Mumble at once?
No, this is a record for us.
This is absolutely a record, so congratulations to everybody involved. And look at this, standing right next to me is Trusty Cupboards. G'day, sir. That would be none other than Rad Manly. How are you?
Doing good.
Doing good. Can you believe the chaos here? I'm getting all sorts of, all sorts of tutorials popping up. We don't want them right now. Tell me, you are a little person. Did you play in version 1?
No.
It's so good to see you, Trusty Cupboards. Go on, give us a, you know what, I can hardly hear anything around here. We've got so many shenanigans going on. I hope you're enjoying yourself. I can't wait to see you in our future. And there we go, away from him, our future Let's Plays. Look at this, we've got Rissy down there. We've got Sunny. Hello, Sunny. We've got, who's that? Lasuna, hello to you. We've got Omos, all of these familiar names down here. Miko, hello. Ferti Star, a big hello to you. Do you know what? Honestly, my computer can't handle rendering all of the names, Katella. Like, I can see all the people, but the names pop in and out. Is that normal?
That's been kind of normal.
Okay, I guess it has to do so. Oh, look at that. It is Jinx. Jinx McNinja. G'day, Jinx.
G'day, how's it going?
Very well. It is so loud and chaotic here. I hope you're enjoying our launch. Are you having fun?
Oh, yes. I was about to explode with excitement.
It is
the closer and closer we got to early
access. Yeah, and now you're here. How good does it feel? Are you happy with the client, and are you happy with how the game looks?
Oh, yes. Most definitely.
Good.
And
good.
I can't wait, because for actual, I want the physical collector's edition for my PS3, so I can put it there as well.
Oh, of course. Yeah, there you go, Blindrage. And of course, can't wait to hear about how the PS3 version is running. And I certainly would imagine that a bunch of folk who are here right now are playing it from the PS3. And Lady, hello, Lady. Oh, gosh, you know what? I'm getting lost in here. Did you ever, 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 in your wildest dreams, think that we would end up in a situation like this with, I'd imagine, over 150 people all in one area in Final Fantasy XIV? What are you thinking right now?
I am amazed. It's still astounding that we had so many people join us, but it's at the same time not surprised.
Yeah, exactly. That's our Distant World community. You know what? Speaking of old friends, look who it is standing right next to me. I'm going to shuffle on up to them. Maybe they'll give me a wave. It is our good dancing friend, none other than Scarlet Rosebud. Hey, Tiger. How's it going?
Hello. How are you?
I'm very, very well. What do you reckon? Did you ever, ever think in a million years we'd be standing here amongst all of these people in A Realm Reborn with it looking like this?
No, never. And but it's amazing.
Can I just say that it's amazing you're not dancing? Are you feeling okay?
Well, you know, I'm crying, but the game is lagging a lot for me.
There it is. There you go. And look, I know for a fact, and this is something great to know for our viewers, you are running it on a laptop, is that right?
That's correct.
Okay, so look, if there's ever going to be a stress test for your laptop, it is right here and right now with probably over 150 characters right beside you. Tell us, what is your experience right now?
It's a little chaotic, but a little slow, but I'm seeing everything, I'm hearing everything, so it's worth it.
There you go. It is working, and I'm sure you haven't got the beastliest of laptops. So if you guys watching along from home want to know if it's worthwhile running, it does run, and Scarlet is living proof of that. Although, I think, Scarlett, you can also go and download the benchmark program just to double check before you buy it if you really want to. So yeah, there you go. And look at this, it is Tanya Waterstrike in the background there. We know her as the woman who says no. It is none other than Star Lynn. G'day, Star.
Hi, Sam.
Oh, it's so, so good to see you, and I'm so pleased that you made it here. Come on, give us your thoughts. Are you happy?
I am loving this right now. I am so happy to be back in this game.
We are so pleased to have you back as well. Do you know what? I reckon I could take advantage of your happy situation by asking you a question, but I'm not even going to, because, you know, I'm not going to put you through that today. And I know what the answer would be anyway. Can I just say that it's great to see you here. And what class is your character right now?
Conjurer.
You know what? Right now, I am a conjurer as well. So it's great to see you. And, of course, we hope that you'll be joining us in our future Let's Play episodes here in Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. As we walk around, hopefully any of you guys who are watching along from home will have been here and you can see yourselves in the show It's great to see you. Grog Reloaded, a big hello to you there. Ryder Draconis, some familiar names coming up here. Fenrir, that's a classic name right there. Jigs McNinja, of course, you've seen. There's Exo, good to see you, mate. We've got Eormen, we've got T'Chai. Look at all these people, look at these mounts at the back here. Katella, I understand that I'm going to be able to get a special mount at some point. Is that true?
That's true.
And in the meantime, we can see Ventus Avalon has got one there. Margoose, big hello to you. Mithri Manithil, hello. Rex Carmine, that name's ringing a bell, is it? That can't be the Rex we know and love from version one, is it?
It is indeed. Welcome back to Ul'dah.
Oh, thank you, Rex. It's great to see you here. What do you reckon? Did you ever think you'd be standing amongst so many people in this new client?
Speechless.
You're speechless.
That's all I can say.
Absolutely. It is just a unique feeling being here. I'm so glad that you're here to share the fun and the momentous occasion that this is with us here today. Thank you, Rex, for coming along. We've got EP Moonshadow. It's the Zen Wing. G'day, sir.
Hello.
Oh, it's so good. You're showing off on your mount there, and it's got the special barding. How good is it being here amongst our old and new Distant World family?
Let's go 1 to 10 on my team.
1 to 10, it's a 50. You know what? I'm so pleased that you made it through to A Realm Reborn. Can't wait to see more of you in the upcoming Let's Play series as well. Professor Hojo, big hello to you. Mega Blackthorn, you know what? We'd be here all day if we said hello to everybody. I just want to make sure that you all realize, hello, all realize that we do appreciate you coming out. Of course, Katella, these folk have been standing here for a very long time, if I'm not mistaken.
They have. They've been great.
Patiently waiting for us to get through to the outside world. This, folks, is what it's like to be amongst the esteemed nature of a Distant World player. They have the patience of a saint. And, of course, if you'd like to join the ranks of Distant World, all you need to do is pop along and apply at the Distant World Engine site. And we've linked that down in the description below this video. You, too, can be here in Final Fantasy A Realm Reborn and joining us alongside the likes of Nikos Guildmaster. G'day, Nikos. Very, very well. You're showing off there. You've got a very fancy looking bard. You know what? I'm not even going to ask you about it because I'm sure that'll come up in a future episode. But let us know. Are you happy to be here or what?
It's amazing. I don't even know what to say.
It's incredible, isn't it? When you think about it, you know, we are all real people. We're not just NPCs. This is, folks, don't forget, a collection of over 160 real life people who have given up their time and waited patiently to be here in order to take part in our inaugural Let's Play Episode 1 celebrations here in Eorzea in Distant World. And I thank each and every single one of these amazing people from the bottom of my heart. I am absolutely blown away. Katella, I can already tell as I come and sit next to you over here, this is going to be one hell of a series. Look, I'm sure you've got lots of things lined up for us in future episodes, am I right?
Oh, yeah.
We are, folks, going to be on an adventure of the likes you've never seen before. This is going to be an incredible journey here in Distant World, here in Eorzea, the brand spanking new Eorzea that you're looking at right now. And again, if you don't get impressed by what you're seeing right now, then seriously, you don't have a beating heart in your chest. Surely you want to come along and join us. I encourage you to do exactly that, as I'm sure would Picoman. Pico, have you been busy already? I mean, we're mere hours into the game. Tell me, have you been crafting up a storm?
Yep, been crafting going and sound.
There's nothing that's going to stop him. And of course, you guys will remember Picoman from our very first series, and he now is one of the most respected crafters, as far as I can tell anyway. And I can't wait, Pico, for you to lead us through the new crafting system here in Final Fantasy XIV A Realm Reborn, because I do understand it's changed just a little bit. Is that right?
Yep, it's much more intuitive, and it's really good for me to manage the enemies as well.
Good. A lot easier. That means it's good for me. You know what? I can see standing next to me there again, Rust. Rust, I want to know, how long did you spend in the character creator? Because that's a fine-looking character that you've got going on there. Did you spend hours in there?
I spent all the betas in there.
So a bit of a favourite for you. Are you happy with the result? She looks awesome.
Yeah, I got what I wanted.
Now, also, I can see that you're holding a book. I think that we're going to have to wait till another episode to talk about that. But without spoiling the plot, are you one of the new classes in the game?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so we're definitely going to come and speak with you in upcoming episodes. Who's that over in the background? It is Blindrage. Blind, all got a bit much to you, taking a break over the back there?
Yeah,
I'm tired.
You're tired. You know what? I am exhausted as well, folks. It's been an exceptionally busy weekend for everybody involved. We had our early access launch last night, my time. That was 2 a.m. in the morning for Pacific. I think it was like what, 4 or 5 in the morning for those folks on the East Coast. And most of these people have probably been up since then, and they're here right now. This is unbelievable. Do you know what? Someone else I know has been up a long time before we sign off in this episode. That would be one of our crazy Dutchmen, none other than Gur. Gur, are you there and are you awake?
Of course I'm awake. Oh, I wouldn't miss this for the world.
They're good, and I'm so glad, so pleased that you managed to be here. Of course, you were with us in our early access launch many, many hours ago now, but it's been a very tiring experience for everybody involved, but I don't think it gets any better than this. Look, you were saying earlier on that it'd be interesting to see how many people turn up for our first show. Did you have any idea it would be this huge?
No.
I mean, we can hope for the best. Well, we knew it was going to be big, but did you honestly think it was going to be this big? It's ridiculous.
I saw how many people there were this morning. At least for me, it was 11 in the morning that the game started, so there were quite a few people back there.
Oh, it's unbelievable. Yeah, I know. And you, of course, know our Mumble server has been maxed out. It is sitting at, oh, I don't even know, I've lost count now. It's over 120, I think.
It's maxed out how many times?
Three or four, I think.
Yeah, four.
Katella, you're constantly having to go in there and increase it. It is absolutely unbelievable. So there you go, folks. Have a look around. This is Distant World. This is Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. This is a brand new Let's Play series for us. I have no idea what to expect coming up, but I can guarantee you one thing. It is going to be a whole bunch of fun. It's going to be community-based. It's going to be involving you watching along from home and every single one of our Distant World members here in-game and here in Mumble. And again, I thank you all for your patience and for the fact that you've come back and joined us here in this next phase of our community. You know what? I think it's time for us to wrap up here. Or Katella, you're going to get mad at me. I'm going to come over and stand next to you. What do you think we're going to be doing in our next episode, Katella? Any idea whatsoever?
This might cause some laughs, but I think we're actually going to deal with your inventory situation.
Oh, you're joking. Shiv! Shiv! Did you have anything to do with this, Shiveria Moonrunner?
I may not have to bribe the Miqo'te right next to you that Katella is.
Ah, I see. Okay, so in other words, it was all your fault.
Yes.
When do we get a kill coach?
Exactly.
Okay, well, look, you know what? I'm not going to disagree, Katella. If I look at my inventory now, it is 95 out of 100. It's getting just a little bit tightly packed in there. So I've no doubt Katella got a whole bunch of junk. Hello, Shiv. I've got a bunch of junk that's carried over from version 1 that I really don't need anymore, right?
I'm not picking that at all. I'm going to back away.
You back away. And there's Amadeus. G'day, Amadeus.
Hello.
Good to see you here. Are you going to be looking forward to our adventures moving forward? Look, you know, I know I've got to clean out my bags, but I really want to get out there and start killing some stuff. Have you been doing that? Have you been questing already?
I've been trying every single aspect of this game. Crafting, which I am actually addicted to, which I never thought I would be.
There you go. So obviously,
I've been killing more. Well,
Pico said that the crafting had changed, so obviously it's a lot more accessible now.
I find that in other games, I find crafting like a headache. Because it's like you have to think about this synthesizing, but this just lays it all out in front of you and explains it all the way.
Good, you know what? I can't wait. I really can't wait because crafting in the old game was, well, let's face it, it was a bit of a challenge to poor old Sambo. So we'll see how we go. All right, there we go. Katella, I think it's time for us to wrap this up. What do you think?
I think so.
It's been an exhausting day. How long have you been up for today? Because you were up at the early access. What was that, about 2:30 a.m.? Something like that?
2 a.m., yep.
And so it's been a very, very long day. You know what? I'm going to position myself out the front. Look at that view. It is just gorgeous. Katella, how many screenshots have you taken?
Oh, too many.
Way too many. Look, let's get ourselves...
You should see the water.
Really?
The water looks really cool.
I haven't paid close attention to it just yet, but I can't wait. This is going to be an incredible journey, folks. Look at that. This is Distant World as the day breaks here in the East Shroud in Eorzea. We have got so many amazing adventures coming up. I just simply cannot wait. This is Distant World. This is our party full of familiar faces here. We've got Katella. We've got Blindrage. We've got Merik. We've got Pico. We've got Leo. Lady, Clax, and Seyo. And of course, behind us there are the amazing members of Distant World, who once again I thank for giving up their time and joining us here today. We have made history here today. We've broken so many internal community records that I can't begin to imagine whenever we could possibly break them ever again. And each and every single one of you have been an important part of that. And as I go down the mumble list there, there are familiar names, there are new names, and of course we welcome all of our new players to Distant World and welcome you watching along from home as well to our Let's Play series. And reminding you, if you'd like to take part in any of our shenanigans here, every single day we have something going on in-game and on our community websites. All you need to do is apply at distantworld.engine.com and then one of our officers will review your application, and if you're successful, you will get instructions on how to join us in all of our activities. Katella, I don't think there's anything else we can say now. Is there anything you wanted to cover off before we go?
Not that I can think of at the moment.
Not that you can think of at the moment. I think it is time for us to dip out. So once again, folks, on behalf of myself, Sambo, Seraphis Thrallwyn, Katella, Blindrage, Merik, Pico, Lady, Clax, and Seyo for helping me out with this fantastic episode 1 of our Let's Play Final Fantasy XIV in a Realm Reborn Let's Play series. It's us saying take care. Hope you guys are having a great week wherever you are in the world. We do look forward to seeing you next time. We will see you then, and bye-bye.
Bye.
See you next time.
Thank you.